Hi, my name is Faith Murray. I'm 13 years old and I'm visually impaired. I'm here today to explain my needs and how I can be independent for the next 4 years. I was born 4 months early, causing my retinas to detach, which caused me to become visually impaired. I have attended West Sand Lake Elementary, Miller Hill Sand Lake Elementary, and Algonquin Middle School. I am a good student because I can do all my work. So now onto my equipment. To start off, I have my closed circuit television, or CCTV for short. I use it to enlarge paperwork, as you can see here. And I can also press this button and then press the square button to read the document. To the left is the Braille writer. I use it to type Braille documents. And if you don't know what Braille is a system of reading using your fingers, not your eyes. But you do need special paper. It's about 8.5 by 11 inches. Braille is made up of certain points on a cell. Each key on the Braille writer represents a different point on the Braille cell. And if I combine different points, it will equal letters, words, symbols, numbers, punctuations, etc. Behind that is the large print keyboard. I use it to type printed documents using this piece of equipment right here. This is a tablet. I use it in two different ways. One as a computer, so I can access Google Docs, Google Classroom, Google or the internet, and my Gmail account, as well as, even though I don't use a Google Drive, and Arrow Park homepage on this. And I also use this to see what everyone else is seeing on the smart board. So basically, if the teacher hooks up a computer to my computer, then I'm able to see what everyone else is seeing. So now onto some more equipment over here. This is a 2020 pen. I use this, just a black marker that I use for plotting points on a graph, or if I ever need to draw any diagrams, even though it's my weakness. To the right of that is the abacus. I use it to do addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division if I do not have a calculator, but it's a lot longer. Now let me just get this on. This is the iPad that I use. Right now it's on the calculator. This is how I do math normally. Like, if I don't have a calculator with me, I have to do this the long way. And I also use this for audiobooks. So if I can't get anything in Braille, then I'd have to listen to it either on this or my TVI would just be reading. And to the right of that is the Braille note taker. Now I know that this is used for typing documents in Braille, and I have not gotten any training on it. Well, I have not done that much on it. I know I'll be getting training at the end of July this year. And a few other needs. One, whenever I'm moving around, I have to have the lights on. Otherwise, I'll be using sighted guide. Now, sighted guide is where I grab onto somebody's arm, in this case, my TBI. And sometimes I will have the cane in non-use in my right hand. And it's basically, I'm just walking behind my guide. My TBI brails and transcribes any paper. So if I have just done an assignment, I would normally give it to the TBI to write on, but then I'd have to turn it in myself. Everything needs to be brailed ahead of time. So make sure to give papers to the TBI before I need them. So now to independence. First of all, I am in a normal class. Well, that's how it's been for the past 8 or 9 years. And I'm able to follow any rules and or directions. And I'm able to follow them the first time they are given, not the second or third. Second, I'm responsible for my own work. So any assignments that I'm given, if the assignment is in Braille, I'm able to do it independently. If not, I need help. And I'm responsible for my own work, so that means once I get it, I have to do it either the day it's assigned or the next day. Well, the school rule this year is the day it's assigned is the day you do it and you turn it in the next day. And I have to turn it into the TBI to write on, and then I just hand it in. And then third, I don't really need an aide with me in the cafeteria or at my locker, but I do need an aide getting on, well, trying to find my bus in the afternoon and getting into the building in the mornings. And finally, this is something to do with my transport. I use this piece of equipment. It's called a white cane. It's not a walking stick, and they use it to walk. Just be careful, because I'm not very safe with this thing. I run over, there might be a small chance that I might run into something or someone. So be careful, because I might hurt someone. So in conclusion, I'm looking forward to coming here to the high school next year and for many years to come. Just note that I may be disabled, but I'm in a normal class I'm in a normal class, even though I have needs, but I'm able to be independent either way.